Hello there. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a very simple applique that is inspired by the shape of your name. So let's start by creating a name. And the name part I obviously can make if I just have Embrilliance Essentials. The next two pieces, in order to be able to accomplish what we're doing, you would need to have Embrilliance Enthusiast, and you would also need Embrilliance StitchArtist, just level one, in order to do exactly what I'm doing. So let me show you. First, I'm going to create my name. Now, this is kind of a boring shape right here. I think I want to use a more elaborate font, and I'm going to use one of the fonts that I digitized. So let's see, Greenville Script. Okay, that'll work. It's kind of a funky type. I don't like the way this is kind of rotated. It's supposed to be sort of whimsical and be kind of casual of a script, but I'm going to kind of push it together and get that overall shape. The next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to create a knockdown stitch area. And the way that I do that is I go to utility and I create a add knockdown stitching. Now we're going to experiment a little bit with the add knockdown stitch area, specifically with the inflation. Now I want to create a shape that is inspired by the shape of my name here, but I want to give it a little bit more volume. So I'm going to say, let's inflate it like 20 millimeters. That may be too much, but we could come back and redo it. So let's say, okay. And actually that looks pretty good. Anywho, maybe a little bit bigger. I'm going to say undo. So we will go back to utility and knockdown stitching. Let's say 25 millimeters. That is about, oops, I just had my E selected. Got to redo that. So let's select everything. We'll go to utility, add knockdown stitching, and make the inflation 25 millimeters and say, okay. All right, now I have my shape. That part right there, the adding the knockdown stitching, that is a enthusiast only feature. Okay, so you have to have Embrilliance Enthusiast to be able to do that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this shape and I'm going to go into create mode, which is the mode that you get if you get any of the StitchArtist products. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this shape and I'm just going to convert it. Right now it's a fill, albeit it's kind of a lighter fill because it's a knockdown stitch area. And instead of doing a fill, I'm going to select this button up here to do a run. So now I have just an outline right here. If I wanted to do this as an applique, then what I would need is I would need a couple of runs. The first run would go on to my base fabric, and that was just, well, I'll do a preview of the stitch out in just a second, but that first outline stitching would go onto the base fabric to show me where to lay down my applique fabric. The next stitching is going to actually tack down that applique fabric onto the base fabric. Then we're going to put the letters on top. So what I need here is I need to duplicate this, and I can do that by just saying Command C, Command V to copy and paste it. And now I have another instance of it. But I probably want to change the color. So let's just make it some random color. And I also probably want to change the stitch type. Right now it's just a single. If I'm doing like a raw edge applique, I want to create a more prominent stitch. So I'm going to change this to a bean stitch, and that will give it a little bit more heft. I also now need to change the order of my elements. So I'm going to take my letters and move them to the end. Let's preview what this is going to look like stitched out. Okay. So first we have the white area. Now imagine I'm stitching this applique onto a pair of jeans. This stitching right here will just go right on the jeans, okay? And that is showing us where to lay down the applique fabric. Okay, so we stop there, we put the applique fabric down, and then this stitching goes around and it is tacking down that applique fabric onto the jeans. Great. And then I could, since it's a raw edge applique, I could trim it now or I could just wait till I'm done. Because with a raw edge applique, you want to leave the raw edge of the fabric just sort of hanging out there. And it's kind of like a fun, cool, casual look. And then finally, I'll stitch down my lettering. Okay? So that's how you make a name applique. It's kind of a fun thing to do. This might be great for like towels where, you know, you have a high nap and doing that applique behind it is going to hold down that nap of the fabric, or it's just sort of a fun casual look. You could do it on a sweatshirt with a really fun fabric. You could use it just about any way. So that's how I would use Essentials and Enthusiast and StitchArtist 1 to create this cool effect.